Okay, we ready?
Just about.
Let's go.
Okay, so this time I've got Andy on the Bon Jovi quiz. This is the third one today. Again, obviously Andy knows the scores that James and Brian got, but I'm not going to tell anyone else the scores just yet. So that's going to be something that we come to when it's all done. So there's 35 questions, Andy. You get 30 seconds per question, like, to answer. You're allowed up to 3 passes. So we will come back to them if you want. To be fair, though, I kind of let Jay have more than 3, so it's up to you how many you want to pass on.
Yeah.
But we'll come back to them, and again, you only get 30 seconds on that. Obviously, no Google or nothing like that, just to make it fair. And yeah, I'll tell you what's right and what's wrong after the podcast has finished, so I'll stay on with you for 2 minutes and go through the answers and that. You ready for the first one?
Yeah, shoot, please, go ahead.
Okay, let's see. So, question one, let me just try and find it. What are John's mum and dad called?
Fucking hell. Shit. Joan and... Is it Joan? Fucking hell. Joan and... Not Tony. Oh my god. Oh, fucking hell, mate.
10 seconds left.
Oh shit. It's John, isn't it? John Bon Jovi Senior. And Joan.
John and Joan.
I'll have to be, yeah. Oh god.
Final answer.
Yeah, go on.
Okay. When is Tico Torres' birthday?
Oh, fuck's sake. What, do you want like a day or can I just give the month?
So you can either guess, I kind of let Brian do this, you can guess either the date, the actual date, so like the day and the number, or the year. I'll let any of them be a pass.
Oh my god. Fuck me. I know it's recent-ish, right? I don't know. I've no idea, mate, honestly, I'll just be guessing, like literally a guess.
May as well.
Like, yeah, go ahead. I forgot, oh, Tico, that must be 70-odd, mustn't he? 1953.
Okay. Name 5 films that John Bon Jovi has starred in.
The Leading Man, Row Your Boat, 2571, New Year's Eve, and that vampire thing. What's it called?
I'll take that.
Yeah.
Pay Forward
was another one. Pay
Forward, yeah. Okay. Where was Richie Sambora's last show with the band?
Oh, fuck. Well, I should know that as well. Oh, my God. Don't know, Cleveland, no idea.
Final answer?
Yeah.
Okay. What was the last single by the band to reach top 40 in the UK?
Top 40. Oh god. Because we can.
Final answer?
Yeah.
Okay. Number 6. Who was the band's official photographer during the late 80s?
Oh, that was Weiss, was
final answer?
Yeah.
Okay. Number 7. In the film New Year's Eve, John performs 3 songs. What are they called?
Nah, I still don't know them. No idea, mate. It's not... No, next.
What was the band almost called?
Oh, fuck. Oh, fucking hell. Oh God. No, I don't know.
Do you want to pass?
I know I've read it somewhere, you know what I mean, but I just can't like.
I'll put that one as a pass because you might know it. That's like it might just be your man block. Number nine, who featured heavily? I always say heavily in the Christmas video. Please come home for Christmas.
Oh, Cindy Crawford.
It's mad how everyone knows that one.
I know, that's just strange, that, isn't it?
Number 10. Where was the This House Is Not For Sale tour start? Where did it start, sorry?
Oh, mate. Fucking hell, I couldn't even tell you the country. Fucking... Oh, God. Iraq.
I think you might be wrong with that one.
Nah, I'm only messing, it was Iran.
We'll move on to the next one if you want.
Didn't he kick it off in Scam?
I wish. Might mean I actually get to go there.
First and last time.
Let's see. I forgot what one we're on. Number 11. I think you should know this one. What was originally planned to be the comeback single when the band came back in 2000?
Yeah, it was. It was the second song, when it say isn't so.
Okay. Final answer.
Yeah.
Matt LeBlanc starred in two videos. What were they?
Ooh. One was Say It Isn't So, and the other one was It was Miracle, I think. Okay. Yeah, Miracle.
Final answer.
Yeah.
Okay. Three songs from the Keep the Faith album reached the UK top 10 in the singles chart. What songs were they? So you only get three attempts.
Okay.
Of guessing all three.
Yeah, Keep the Faith. Bed of Roses. Dry County.
Okay. Final answer, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. No one's got this one yet, and I'm not surprised. Back in 2009, John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora had done a cover of Stand By Me with an Iranian superstar. What was his name?
Oh, it was Andy Sutton. Andy Pandy. What was his second name? No, I'm never going to guess his second name. I thought it was Andy, so I can have like half a point.
I'll give you the full point for that one, to be fair.
Really?
Yeah, because okay. Well then.
Nice one,
what was the last song that the band played on the 2011 tour? So what song ended the tour?
Fucking hell. Just a guess. These Days.
Okay. Final answer, yeah?
Yeah.
16. John done a song for Gary Barlow's play called Beautiful Day, but what was the play called?
Fuck. Really don't know, to be honest, no.
Want to leave that one?
Yeah. I'm Beautiful Day, fuck it, I don't know. Yeah.
Okay, number 17. Bon Jovi have only ever won one Grammy Award, but how many times have they been nominated?
Just a guess, three.
Okay. Who did the band have open for them for 20 European shows during the These Days tour?
20. God. I should know because I attended three of them. Fuck it, who was there? All three gigs. wasn't Van Halen, they went there that many times. Ugly Kid Joe was at them. Crown of Thorns. Oh God. Thunder.
Okay. Final answer.
Yeah.
Okay. What was John's character in Row Your Boat called?
Don't know. Fucking Roy.
Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
Number 20. What Robbie Williams song have the band performed?
Let me entertain you.
Final answer?
Yeah.
Sound. What song was the band performing when John injured his leg in Helsinki, Finland in 2011?
I don't know. Bad Medicine.
Okay. Final answer?
Yeah.
John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora were on the Big Breakfast Show in 2000 and they went head to head in a competition. What was it called?
Oh, fuck. I've watched that. I did actually watch it live and I've watched it a few times, like on YouTube as well.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, fuck. Battle of the Bonds.
Final answer?
Yeah.
Where was the video for Thank You For Loving Me filmed?
It was like Italy, wasn't it? Or Rome or somewhere? Yeah, Rome.
Okay, final answer.
Or can I be vague and say Italy?
You don't need to, don't worry.
Yeah,
what year did Richie Sambora marry Heather Locklear? What year?
She was fucking about on the These Days tour, weren't she? So I reckon it was 95.
Final answer.
Yeah.
Okay. How many children has David Bryan got that we know of?
he's got that Gabby bird, hasn't he? So there's that. He's got a son as well, I think. I don't know. I'm fucking chatting shit. Two.
How many Tony Awards has David Bryan won?
Again, this is just a guess. Seven.
Okay. How many shows did the This House Is Not For Sale tour have, not including promo?
God. You want like a specific number?
Yeah, like only because obviously it was because it was shorter than the rest. Like,
Well, I mean, this is just a guess, so I'm going to say 48.
Okay. Right, this one I don't think anyone's going to get. I don't know why I've put it in, but you never know. What film was Phil X featured in the making of bonus features? Did you get that then? Because something popped up on mine, sorry.
Yeah, it was... fucking hell, was it that... Oh, what the fuck's it called? Like, Hired Gun?
Final answer?
Yeah, it might not be that, but yeah, Hired Gun.
How old is Phil X?
Oh, Phil, he's in his 50s, and he doesn't look it, but I reckon he's about 53.
Okay. Tico had an endorsement with what drum company from 1984 to 2013?
Pearl.
Okay. Right, this one's quite a long question. What song debuted at number 15 and logs the best start for a non-holiday track since 2001? On the US Billboard Adult Contemporary Radio Airplay chart. Fucking hell, it's a tongue twister.
Well, say that again.
Fucking bastard.
Well, I'm being serious.
I'll try and break it down if you want.
Yeah, go ahead.
What? Oh, I'll do it again. What song debuted at number 15 and logs the best start for a non-holiday track since 2001? on the US Billboard Adult Contemporary Radio Airplay chart?
Fuck. I don't know. Who says you can't go home? I don't know.
Final answer?
Yeah.
Okay. Where was the roller coaster music video filmed?
It was some fair, wasn't it? was it Blackpool? I don't know, fucking somebody, one of these weird fucking fair things in America, like on Long Island or somewhere. I don't know.
Go on, what's your answer gonna be?
Fuck. That, yeah, Long Island, wherever the fuck that is.
So three left. Where is the Crossroads album cover taken?
Fuck, I don't know. It's in some diner, isn't it?
Do you know what it's called?
The diner?
Yeah.
Fucking Fat Moe's.
Oh my god. I should give you a point just for that answer, really.
Fucking hell, man, that's such a random thing.
You'd be surprised, I know people who've been there, and then Brian kind of knew the answer before as well.
Hard Rock Cafe or something, or like fucking Frankie and Benny's?
You were right with diner. It's something diner. I'll give you a point.
Am I doing that bad that I need these sort of like these gifts? Fucking hell, go ahead.
Well, where was the diner?
I don't know. America. No, I don't deserve a point for that, man.
Not to crash that one.
Yeah, fuck that.
Okay, I was kind of Jay. I won't be with you then.
No, don't.
Number 34. John wrote two songs called "Not Running Anymore," excuse me, and "Old Habits Die Hard." What was the film called that he wrote them for?
I haven't seen it. Was it Stand Up Guys?
Final answer?
Yeah, say that.
Okay, and then number 35, Richie Sambora performed live with what R&B singer during the AMAs one year?
BB King.
That your final answer?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see. How many do you think you got out of 35?
I reckon it's around, James is about 8 or 9.
13.
Really?
Yeah, 13. So same as Brian.
Yeah, it's not terrible. It's not good, but it's not terrible.
It's at, like, when I go offline with you now, and I go through them, you'll be like, oh shit, yeah. Honestly. So yeah, we'll wrap this up, and then I'll speak to you now off air, okay?
All right, mate.
All right, nice one, mate.